Today's subject is Pharmaceutics 2. Then the chapter number 3 is Sociology. And the subtopic is Factors Influencing Growth of Drug. In last lecture, we have to see the two factors. That is, first is age and second is the sex. And we have to, in this lecture, we have to see the third factor influencing the growth of drug. That is, body weight. The body weight is important while calculating the dose of the drug. Then what is standards of dose calculating by body weight? The average dose mentioned in the mention is either in the terms of mg per kg of body weight. Means this is the standard which are given in the pharmacopoeia. Means the dose of the drug is according to calculated according to average dose mentioned in either in terms of this mg per kg of body weight, or either it is total single dose for an adult weighing between 50 to 100 kg. This is normal weight, which is the standard while calculating the dose of drug in terms of standard. But in case, for example, obese person, obese patients, or children, or malnourished patient, the dose expressed is not applied in case of, for example, obese patient, because the weight is different, the weight is high according to the standards, average weight in mg per kg, or children, in case of children, the weight is very less, and in case of malnourished patient, the weight is varies according to the malnourished patients. Therefore, these standards are not applied in case of the obese patient, then in case of the children and malnourished patient. Therefore, it should be calculated according to their body weight. Means the dose of the drug in case of obese patient, children and malnourished patients are calculated according to their body weight, and dose is given to the patient. Then the fourth factor is routes of administration. In the routes of administration, that is, we have to take the example of intravenous drug. The intravenous doses are usually required smaller as compared to the oral route of administration, because these intravenous routes are injected directly into the systemic circulation, that is into the bloodstream. Therefore, the onset of action is very quick in case of intravenous route of administration. But at the same time, there are enhances the chances of severe drug toxicity. Means the intravenous doses are usually smaller than as compared to the oral doses. What is the reason? Because the drug administered intravenously enters directly into the bloodstream. Therefore, it directly administered to the bloodstream, therefore the onset of drug action is quick with intravenous drug. But at the same time, they enhance the chances of drug toxicity, because it is directly linked to the bloodstream. Therefore, the effectiveness of the drug formulations are generally controlled by the routes of administration. Means, for example, the intravenous drug are usually contain small doses, then oral doses are given the effect within the live doses. Means there is the dose control by the routes of administration. Then next is the fit. This is the time of administration. Means in case of with presence of food or without food. Means empty stomach. For example, the presence of food in the stomach delay the absorption of drugs. For example, when the drugs are more rapidly absorbed from empty stomach. Agar jo drug empty stomach mein, jinka empty stomach mein absorption fast hota hai, agar wo drug aap in presence of food denge, to unka absorption slow jayega. means the drugs which are more able to absorb from the empty stomach. Therefore, these type of drugs, this type or amount of drugs which are very effective, when is taken before meal. Before meals means empty stomach. And if it is given after meal means it is may not be that much effective when taken drug during or after meal, because these drugs are more rapidly absorbed from the empty stomach. Means these drugs for absorption, it is given in the given before meal, not to the after meal. The second example is irritating drug. The irritating drugs are better tolerated if administered after meal. Irritating drug को कौन देना चाहिए? It is after meal because it irritates the empty stomach. For example, iron, arsenic, cod liver oil. These are the examples of irritating drugs which should be always be given after meals. If it is given after meal, it does not irritate the empty stomach. So this is the example of time of administration. In this lecture, we have to see the three factors influencing dose of drug. First is body weight, second routes of administration, and third is time of administration. We have to see revise one by one. The body weight, according to standards, the net body weight should be mentioned either in mg per kg of body weight or total single dose of adults weighing between the. This is the standard 50 to 100 kg. But if the weight is different in case of, for example, obese patient, the weight is very high. The children weight is very low, and malnourished patient, the weight is differ from the standard weight. Then for this type of patient, the dose should be calculated according to its body weight. Then second, routes of administration. For example, in case of intravenous routes, the dose required is very small, is as compared to the oral route of administration, because when intravenous routes are given to the patient, it is directly goes to the systemic circulation and the onset of action is very fast, but at the same time enhances the drug toxicity in the patient. Therefore, the effectiveness of these drugs formulations are generally controlled by routes of administration. Means onset of action is fast or slow, it is depends on this routes of administration. And next is the time of administration, means presence of food or without food in the stomach. Various drugs in the presence of food in the stomach delay the absorption of drugs. For example, those drugs are more rapidly absorbed from the empty stomach. Therefore, these type of drugs are given before meal because it absorbs more rapidly from the empty stomach. This type of drug, if it is given in between or after meal, the absorption is less. The second example is irritating drugs. Irritating drugs are better tolerated if it is administered to the after meals. For example, iron, arsenic or cod liver oil should be always be given after meal. So these are three examples of factors influencing dose of